Right now, NASA teams are working on repairing the leak on board the Artemis 1 mission. Taking a live look right now at the SLS rocket at Launch Pad 39B. The work will continue as NASA waits for extension approval for a system test.
NASA revealed today that scientists are hoping to attempt a launch later this month sometime. West Coast Scott Hyler listened in to the update.
NASA launch teams still aiming for a launch attempt this month, but they'll need approval from the U.S. Space Force as they control the Eastern Range and oversee public safety for all launches from the Cape.
They've been very gracious and understanding of what we're trying to do. I'll reiterate to the fact that our job is to live to their requirements. It is their range.
NASA needs a waiver for an extension on a check of the SLS rocket's self-destruct system. Currently, the system batteries are up against a 25-day limit. The new launch windows of September 23rd and 27th are beyond that. Another hurdle for the launch teams to cross is that they need to fully fill both sections, the upper and the lower, inside that SLS core stage. This is to make certain that that fix to the hydrogen leak is working properly. That tanking is planned for September 17th after a seal is replaced. And out on the pad, they can use cryogenic fuel while trying a new method to avoid issues seen during the two launch attempts.
Changing our concept of operations to reduce the pressure and flow changes during tanking, so we're calling it a kinder and gentler approach to tanking.
With the team confident of the path forward to those two launch attempt windows, also comes a reminder.
The administrator said it best when the cost of failure is much higher than the cost of scrubbing. And I can't say it better than that. We have an obligation to get this right.
NASA's next chance to get it right is at 6:47 a.m. on September 23rd. On the Space Coast, Scott Hyler, West 2 News.